Let's get an update on the weather now from Pag-asa forecaster Ana Florent Munta. Ana, what do you have for us?
Yes, good morning, Ma'am Nikki. We're now monitoring a low pressure area located at around 310 kilometers east of Borangan City, Eastern Samar. This LPA and the southwest monsoon will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over the whole Visayas, Mindanao, Catanduanes, Sorsogon, Albay, Masbate, and the northern portion of Palawan. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country are expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Based on our forecast, the temperature range here in Metro Manila is from 27 to 33 degrees Celsius, while in Baguio City is from 18 to 22 degrees and in Tagaytay is 22 to 33 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest from Pag-asa. This is Ana Florent Horda. Good morning.
All right. Good morning, Ana. Thanks. The Philippine Environment Department clarifies all 22 reclamation projects in Manila Bay have been suspended. Now, this comes after President Marcos earlier said there is still one remaining project that was allowed to proceed. The projects are halted to give way to the assessment of their impact on the environment.
Upon clarification with the President, and as you will see on the suspension, all are under review. The declaration is really that all of these projects are suspended at this point. No? So all are under review. We have to take our time, really beginning with those that are ongoing because they're in fact already impacting the areas. And then we will graduate to those that are in fact still not yet begun.
Oceana Philippines, a group dedicated to protecting the world's oceans, lauds the president's decision.
Philippines have very high in marine biodiversity. Hindi talaga bagay, hindi talaga dapat magkaroon ng reclamation sa Pilipinas. Or yung mga nangyari sa places like Japan, they're spending billions of money para lang ibalik yung mga formerly very rich subtidal areas at saka coastal areas sila from reclamation. Kailangan natin i-prevent before it happens.
Hundreds of foreign vessels sighted in the West Philippine Sea. Based on the latest monitoring of the armed forces of the Philippines, most of them are Chinese ships. China is claiming jurisdiction over almost the entire South China Sea, including the West Philippine Sea.
In our last monitoring, abot ng ano eh, malapit-lapit sa 500 siguro. Almost lapas 400 based on our last monitoring. Among EEC, in West Coast area lang, ha? Mga 400 plus. That's my Chinese lang. Siguro mga 85% doon, Chinese.
Yung pagpaprovide ng...
For the chief of the AFP, the presence of foreign ships in the country's territory highlights the need to pursue the military's modernization program.
Hindi lamang tayo nakafocus sa Ayungin, no? Sa Ayungin Shoal at sa BRP Sierra Madre. And marami rin tayong mga ibang mga isla na we are occupying, and we also need funds in order for us to improve the facilities there. So kailangan talaga natin na palakasin pa yung ating mga, yung presence, no? Yung presence natin sa West Philippine Sea, and this would entail more funds.
General Romeo Bronner Jr. visited the Western Command headquarters of the AFP in Puerto Princesa, Palawan Thursday, boosting the morale of soldiers confronting Chinese aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Members of the Philippine Navy, meanwhile, shared details of their latest encounter with China. Lieutenant Junior Grade Darwin Daplin says the Chinese ships tried to ram their vessel. He says China's vessels came as close as 5 meters to resupply the boats.
Nasa 24 meters na po yung boats natin na pinagdala pagkunta doon. Medium foot po yun, sir. So,
and who owns this, sir?
Ito na po yung civilian chartered na po. Delikado talaga siya, sir, kasi yung mga bangka natin is made from wood. Anything na mangyari dyan na mabanggamang yan, or matamaan man yan ng matindi. Hindi natin alam kung makakabalik pa talaga yung pangkalan kapag nasira. So, very endangering talaga yung ginawa.
Meanwhile, Lieutenant Ramsey Gutierrez says, the supplies they were supposed to deliver to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre were ruined because of the water cannon incident.
Nabasa ilan yung mga bigas. Then yung ibang mga food provision is tinamaan din ng water cannon. So nagsabog-sabog may mga nasirang food provision. Yung mga gulay, kape. Yung mga panahon yun, ma'am. At that moment, ma'am, composed pa rin naman kami, ma'am. Then we are continuously coordinating with higher headquarters for the kung ano magiging action namin, ma'am. And to safely navigate lang yung mga chart boats natin. Na-vaccine talaga siya, which is na-restrict na siya sa maneuverability. So there are two Chinese militia vessels on Herford and Starford, so kaliwat kanan, ma'am. And then yung Coast Guard vessel nasa likod naman, ma'am. So there is no choice for the boat to sail away from the intended track.
The Philippine Defense Secretary expresses his outraged over the Chinese Coast Guard's latest act of aggression. Now, Secretary Gilbert Chiodoro says China is using the presence of Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA sites, to conceal its true intentions in the West Philippine Sea. He also brands as an insult insinuations that the actions of the Philippines are being influenced by the U.S.
The Philippines will not bend over, as the president said. And we will not give in to unreasonable demands. And I think the narrative is being changed somehow, that it is a result of our engagements with the United States. I think the true intent of China in this incident is obvious. For me, I believe that the presence of Philippine bases with EDCA sites is being used as a cover for their true intent of dominating and exploiting the West Philippine Sea.
A top Philippine Coast Guard official calling out fellow Filipinos who appear to be siding with China. In a strongly worded tweet, Commodore J. Tariela, Coast Guard spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, says Filipinos who defend or make excuses for China's aggressive behavior should be deemed a traitor to the Philippines and to its people. Tariela adds, while he recognizes freedom of speech, actions by acting as China's mouthpiece.